2, 1. Down. Yeah.
Warning. Please do not get attached to any of your builds or loadouts. They will get nerfed tomorrow or in a month. Don't be a tree hugger. When you play the Division 2, take all your builds with a grain of salt. Nothing will be set in stone, because the devs will nerf it for no reason but their own. That being said, play at your own risk. Don't get mad. Get even. No cheat or hacking here. All talents and gear are giving me the high damage. I am using what the developer set into the game. My channel is never to exploit a hack or a cheat, or to self-promote a hack or a cheat for subscribers to subscribe to my channel. I care and help my fellow subs that are my extension of my family. And that being said, it's about time. Cheaters are caught. Do the crime, do the time.
Yo, this is weird. I do not like True Patriot at all. I do today, holy shit. This is fucking crazy. Here we go.
Rifle, baby. All the way, baby, rifle. Boom, 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 boom. Pick up that shield. Pick up that shield. Pick up that. Pick up that arm. Yeah. Oh my god, carpal tunnel. He's down. What up, Division 2 players? This is Tips and Tricks for Division 2, and I am bringing you a crazy Baker's Dozen rifle. True Patriot. Yeah, True Patriot. I was a non-believer, but now I am a believer. Holy crap, guys. We're getting to build real quick. Here we go, guys. So True Patriot, guys, I was really astounded that it stacks. Alright? It's supposed to do what Striker is supposed to do. And it didn't. Striker is really, really messed up. The devs messed up Striker. So I'm really at it. I'm against it at myself right now. I love Striker. I hate Striker. It work and it won't work. But True Patriot will work 24/7 12, man. It works, guys. Red, white, and blue means stacks, stacks, stacks. Okay? Plain and simple. It stacks, guys. Alright, so I'm running the minigun right here, guys, for the barrage talent. That's 5% rate of fire. And then you have a med kit thing. That's a talent. I forgot the name of it, but it'll give you 30% armor, alright, bonus armor, when you proc it for like 10 seconds. So you can still have your neck out and shoot NPCs, whatever you want. Alright, so Baker's, and it comes with a foam grenade. You throw a foam grenade on NPCs, lasts for like 4 seconds. You can shoot whatever's trapped in the foam grenade, kill them fast, hard, that's it. So we've got Baker's Dozen here, guys. Holy crap, guys. This is amazing. Perfect lucky shot. Magazine capacity is increased by 30%. Missed shots from cover have a 100% chance to return to the magazine. This is what I used to have, lucky shot, on my Aces build with the SVD. So literally, and it hits harder than SVD. That's ridiculous. All right, so we've got a 30% rate of rifle damage and 10% critical hit damage. And rate of fire is 3.6 rate of fire. We've got a 14 rifle damage there, 13 critical hit damage, and 9% damage to target out of cover. And the RPM, it is what it is. I've got this modded as stability, accuracy, alright, our small RDF scope with 50% stability, with an angle grip of 10% stability, all stability, guys. I ain't gonna look through a scope. Too much time taken to shoot an enemy to look through a scope. I'm sorry, I can't do it. Not me. Alright, we have a tightly packed magazine. It's plus 5 more rounds. So without it, it would be pretty much minus 16, so 24. There you go, guys. So both of these are modded out just the same. And of course, lightning rod here, it is what it is. It's just here for looks. there's no holster talent anymore. They nerfed the shit out of that. Again, we're going to get now to the True Patriot gear set of wondrous awesomeness. I was totally against this, guys, for the longest, all right? But they gave it a buff. They made it what it is, a True Patriot. It gives your friends a buff. You don't understand. It gives your friends a buff, and it gives you a buff. It stacks, ridiculously stacks. Okay, 2 pieces, 30% ammo capacity, 3 pieces, 30% magazine size, 4 pieces, red, white, and blue. Every 2 seconds, enemies you shoot receive a stacking debuff of red, white, and blue. Red amplifies, okay, the enemy's damage taken by 8%. White, shooting the enemy repairs you and your allies' armor by 5% once every second. Blue decreases the enemy's damage dealt by 8 per second. So you're giving out damage, you're not taking damage, and you're helping your friends repair their damage from not taking damage, if that made any sense. All right, full flag, enemies that die while under the effect of all three debuffs create a 5 meters explosion, dealing damage equal to their total health and armor. So if they die with probably 2 bars of their thing, that's the damage they're going to deal exterior to every other NPC next to them. Okay, explosion damage reduces on name enemies' death. The mask here is 50% weapon damage, headshot ain't high. I got this modded out. Protection from elites. The chest piece will give you another talent. I don't like the backpack that much. I'm not gonna get into that. But so the chest piece will give you an additional talent. Waving the flag increases red, white, and blue rotation speed to 15 seconds. It's crazy, guys. All right, so now we have the holster, 50% weapon damage, 12,000 health. We've got a Gilligard backpack here. I got this here because of the 5% total armor. I want to be a little more tanky. Core attributes 106,905 armor. We've got weapon handling 8%, 2% critical chance, modded out with 11% protection from elites, and of course we have composure. Sorry about that. While in cover, increases total weapon damage by 15%. This is amazing, guys. So you have this talent here, right? Full flag, red, white, and blue, and you have composure. It stacks. It's crazy. These together, it's a killer. It's a killer. Okay, overload armaments, 10% rifle damage. So overload armaments, you cannot stack this, guys. If you have 3 of these things, like the mass overlord, backpack overlord, and a glove overlord, it's not gonna stack. It caps off at 10%. You can only have 1 overload armament, gear, to have this 10% rifle damage. All right, just to let you know that. Same thing with Fremen's group. Core attribute is 50% weapon damage, repair skill is 12%, critical chance is 3%, and we have a knee pad here, a 50% weapon damage, 2.7 critical chance, and we have the hive, the stinger hive. It's crowd control, guys. It's great. Alright, so the mod is 3.7 damage, we've got 4.9 duration, we've got stinger charges, a plus 4, and we've got a fixer drone. So when you're shooting each NPC one by one, of course you're gonna need something to heal you, but I do like my fixer drone, guys. It will help you shoot a lot longer and make you a lot tankier. You see that health? It's 1,152,000. That's great, guys. So let's see the mods here, guys. We have duration of 6%, we've got armor repair of 5.9, close to 6, and we have a health of it not dying. Health here is 8.6%. The health is for the drone, so it survives damage from all the NPCs around trying to shoot your drone. Alright, and that's it. So this is the build, guys. Make it your own. And yeah, you could just change the gloves here and make an assault rifle build. That's how easy peasy Japanesey this whole new update of Warlords and them nerfing everything we had earlier. So it's easy peasy Japanese, man. You just put shit together, run out there and shoot shit. All right, there's no huge deep builds anymore, guys. No more. And your damage is no deep damage anymore. So that's why these assholes are doing that crazy hacking, whatever. I ain't doing that shit, man. I like to play it as is, do what I can with my build, and rock on. All right, y'all. Make this your own. Peace, one love, and I'm out.